Will living to 200 years old be tiny or huge by 2030? Meet Laura Deming, founder of the Longevity Fund. She is on a mission to transform aging and life expectancy. And meet Aisha. She's 20 years old and wants to live to 200 years old. I'm Simon Darling. Welcome to Life in 2030. At the end of this video, I make a prediction about how huge living to 200 years old will be by 2030, on a scale of 1 to 10. To answer this, we look at the technology, the companies, what's to love, and jobs. First, we look at technology. The technology to extend life by removing life-shortening zombie cells will be solved by 2030. As Aisha gets older, zombie cells known as senescent cells accumulate, causing damage to vital tissues, leading to disease and death. Laura and longevity researchers are putting huge amounts of effort into finding the chainsaw that will kill off these zombies. The mouse on the left is the same age as the mouse on the right, but clearly looks younger and lived 30% longer. Amazing. Senolytics is the name given to the class of treatments in humans that terminate these zombie cells. One way Laura and others are tackling zombie cells is by trying out stem cell treatments. She's also testing using natural occurring compounds like Fisetin, found in strawberries and apples, and also testing using blood plasma treatments. The technologies to extend life by harnessing young blood may be solved by 2030. As Aisha gets older, she moves from having young blood that is effective at regenerating cells and keeping diseases such as Alzheimer's at bay, to old blood that has a lower concentration of what's needed. Laura and aging researchers are putting effort into understanding young blood and building related treatments. They have shown that mice injected with young blood plasma remain healthier and live longer. The GDF11 molecule is the focus of the technological approaches being tried. This molecule has been shown to be in higher concentrations in young blood. When GDF11 is injected into older mice, it strengthens their heart and restores aging brain and muscle function. But don't try this at home, folks. The San Francisco startup Ambrosia sells transfusions of young blood at a cost of $8,000 for 2 liters. The US Food and Drug Administration in 2019 issued a warning against transfusion services like Ambrosia's, referencing as yet unproven benefits and safety issues. Technology to extend life by refueling cells will be solved. Every 20 years, Aisha has half the level of one essential natural fuel that every cell relies on, called NAD+. This helps keep tiredness and aging at bay. This true Niagen supplement is available today to generate NAD+. From doing the research for this video, I decided to start taking it. It claims to increase NAD+ levels. Do I look like I'm more energetic and less tired? Maybe, maybe not. This treatment is part of a booming industry in life-extending supplements that have varying degrees of scientific proof. This guy, Dave Asprey, claims he will live to at least 180 years old through the supplements he takes. I'm not sure I'd leave that one. By 2030, treatment technologies for all 9 of the aging processes will remain unsolved. For Aisha to live to 200 years old, she needs to not only treat her senescent zombie cells, but stop or reverse 9 changes occurring in her body that scientists have identified that cause aging. Bear with me whilst I say them all, because they're all going on in your body right now, aging you. Cellular senescence, intercellular communication, genomic instability, telomere attrition, epigenetic alteration, proteostasis loss, nutrient sensing, mitochondrial dysfunction, cell exhaustion. Laura and scientists like Aubrey de Grey, a pioneer in this field who has dedicated his life to reversing aging, are hard at work on all of these aging processes, with a total of 59 treatments in development today at the time of recording, with this many per aging process. Although a lot of technologies needed for life extension are solved, a few are not, but all probably need to be, hence this points to it being at the tiny end of the scale by 2030. We now look at companies. I've got a lab coat as the prop to represent the amazing scientists working in these biotech companies. Life expectancy to 200 years old is more likely to be huge if there are lots of unicorns, startup companies that have a valuation of more than $1 billion, and when there's plenty of big multinational companies that are active, represented by an elephant here. Laura's company, the Longevity Fund, is an investor in the sector. She founded her venture capital firm 10 years ago when she was an unbelievably young 17 years old. She has been wanting to cure aging since aged 8, was studying physics at MIT at 14, and dropped out to complete a Teal Fellowship that funds students to build new things rather than complete their studies. She's invested in more than 10 longevity startups. Some of them might already be unicorns. BioAge is a startup on its way to being a unicorn. Kristen Fortney founded the company in 2015. She is working with 45 years worth of patient blood samples, together with AI, to identify molecular drivers of aging and develop treatments. One initiative of BioAge is aiming to activate HIF target genes. These genes are involved in several aging processes. Elevian is an aspiring unicorn that Laura invested in last year. It spun out of the Harvard Department of Stem Cell and Regenerative Biology, with an initial focus to develop medicines that restore the body's youthful regenerative capacity, including the use of GPF-11. There's plenty of multinational companies that are active, including Google, AbbVie, and Taisho. Google has created and invested heavily in its life sciences moonshot, Calico. Its innovations include building customized robots to massively accelerate the throughput of lab work. It was founded by Bill Maris, who started Google Ventures. Multinationals are also partnering. AbbVie, the big pharmaceutical company, recently announced a $1 billion partnership with Calico to develop anti-aging drugs. Licensing treatments from startups is popular. The Japanese pharmaceutical giant Taisho, for example, has an exclusive license with BioAge to commercialize and develop its HIF inhibitor. Although there are startups, but many not yet proven, and because multinational companies are only really just focusing on it, this look at companies points to living to 200 being on the smaller end of the scale by 2030. If you're enjoying this, hit the subscribe button for more predictions about life in 2030. Now we look at whether you and I will be giving 5-star levels of love to living to 200 years old, just as we do to breakthrough cancer treatments that appear today. It gets 5 stars for delivering a healthier life if scientists really crack this. In 2030, Aisha takes Laura's longevity wonder drugs. This not only dramatically slows the aging process, but means Aisha looks and feels younger. What is amazing is that when she's, for example, 120 years old, she's gonna look, perhaps, no more than 40. And many age-related diseases are a thing of the past for Aisha and her friends. The impact on personal relationships is not necessarily all good news, and so gets a 3 stars. Today, Aisha hopes to be happily married like her parents for more than 30 years. In 2030, taking Laura's wonder drugs causes Aisha and her friends to spend hours wondering about questions like, what's it going to be like married for 150 years? Or will I have many marriages over the next century? Will I have children over the course of the next 100 years, with a huge age gap between each one? And friends for life will mean for a lot longer. I highly recommend looking up online the script of a play by Dr. Andrew Harrison that does a brilliant job of bringing all these issues alive. Laura's longevity treatments have a massive impact on working life too, and only gets 3 stars. In 2030, on Laura's anti-aging treatments, Aisha's asking herself, when do I get promoted? My boss Ali is going to live for another 100 years before he retires. I can't wait that long to get his job. How often will I have to retrain? Because the world is changing quickly, will I have to have totally new careers several times? And she's also wondering if retirement ages will change to 100 years old, 150 years old? Societal changes will be big and unpredictable, hence it gets 2 stars. Laura's wonder drugs causes Aisha to see that there is going to be a big shift in the demographic age structure. There are going to be far more older people, and maybe an increase in total population from people living longer if the birth rate doesn't decline. Aisha wonders how living to 200 will change society. Will politics shift to the right as older people tend to vote more conservatively? Who is going to pay for all this? Pensions? Health costs? How will planet Earth support all the extra people living longer? On the basis of whether people will love living to 200 years old or not, it's a mixed picture, hence putting us in the middle of the scale. Put in the comments whether you will want to live to 200 years old. Now we look at jobs. If living to 200 years is huge, then there's going to be lots of jobs hired and fired. Doctors and nurses will one day be fired because people will live longer, healthier lives. On the hired side, there are some job vacancies listed on LinkedIn at the time of recording for BioAge. These include in research, QA, clinical trials, gerontologists, statistics, finance, HR. It's well worth looking at LinkedIn if you're interested in getting a job in the longevity sector. Helping you make good career decisions is a big reason why I'm doing this Life in 2030 channel. Jobs in fast-growing new sectors like longevity are exciting and more secure than in older sectors. I was fortunate to join the e-commerce sector with eBay in its early days and have benefited ever since. Jobs in the sector are all around the world. BioAge are headquartered in Canada, Elevian is in Boston, the Longevity Fund is in San Francisco. You could set up some job alerts for these companies. It's easy to do on LinkedIn, and click to have a look at my Finding Great Jobs for Life in 2030 video. Because there are jobs being hired and fired, but currently at a low level, from a jobs perspective, living to 200 years old is on the small end of the scale. Now we've covered all four sections, it's time for me to make a prediction. We've seen that while some technologies needed may be solved, some will be unsolved. There are interesting companies, but not many unicorns yet. It only gets a 3-star rating overall, and there are a few jobs being hired today. This means that on a scale of 1 to 10, living to 200 is at the tiny end of the scale by 2030, at a 2. By 2040, it might be at a 4 or 5, but not by 2030. If you like this, sign up for my Life in 2030 newsletter for updates on this prediction. Click the subscribe button to get our steady flow of inspiring new predictions. And have a look at our prediction on Hyperloop and one on crypto fashion. I'll see you in the next video.